The following is a RockRadioShow.com exclusive.
Welcome to the Rack Extra right here on WildTalkRadio.com. That's right, we're back. It's another season of Total Divas. I'm Lindsay, he's Rock. I'm super excited. How about you?
Have you missed us? Because I'm excited.
After talking to Eva Marie about season 3, I can't wait. So you know what? I say we jump right into episode 1, season 3, right here on the Rack Extra, right after the break.
I don't care what y'all say.
Hey, this is Trish Stratus, and you're listening to Wild Talk Radio Network. Keep listening, because Stratisfaction is guaranteed.
And welcome back to the Rack Extra right here on WildTalkRadio.com. We are starting off with Episode 1, Season 3. We're getting a recap from WrestleMania 30 with all the girls and their match, kind of their reactions to it. And, well, they are gearing up.
And yeah, they're gearing up. They're excited. Hey, Codebreaker. Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan's the World Heavyweight Champion.
Thank you for not talking about the Thing.
Well, they didn't show the Thing.
Damn right they didn't show the Thing.
Because Michelle's not on the show. If Michelle was on the show, they would show the Thing.
Michelle will never be on the show.
Michelle needs to be on this show. That way we could see The Undertaker on this show.
We'll talk about that later. But anyway, back to the show. Now we're seeing the recap of Brie and Brian's beautiful wedding. Everybody's happy. Everybody's in a good mood. Everything's going smoothly.
And then they're back at Raw doing the yes chant. We kick butt. Look hot doing it. Yes, Natty, you can't say ass.
Natty, you're so cute.
Yes, Natty, you're allowed to say ass. Your TV 14 on E.
Hey, sometimes you just gotta check.
Hey, it's former Rack guest Eva Marie.
And her husband, Jonathan, they're headed to a photo shoot.
Yeah. She wanted to have a real wedding, to have her father walk her down the aisle. Woo! We're doing save the date photos in lingerie. Yes, in lingerie, people. Eva's in lingerie doing save the date photos with a half naked Jonathan.
A little bit racy. That's an interesting classification of a little bit racy.
They want to look back and go, yeah, we were hot. All right, then. Yeah, your parents will freak because those are not engagement photos.
Dude, my parents would freak.
Yeah, they would. So, yeah, now we're going to Monday Night Raw in Nashville, Tennessee.
Nashville!
The site of Night of Champions.
Yes. And, oh, look, it's Rosa Mendes. She's back.
She's been gone a while. Hey, it's the Rebecca and Primo. No, Rosa. No, you don't look 24. Sorry.
You look 30, but you don't look 24.
You don't look 24. They're showing some of her best moments.
But she's back.
She's feeling very good.
She's happy.
Natty's looking at her breasts, hanging out of the how. Yeah. How people won't want to see her looking like that if it was like be a star or anything. Oh, Natty. Natty's a Victoria's Secrets girl herself. Not Frederick to Hollywood like Rosa.
Solidarity, man. Solidarity. Some of the most comfortable bras ever.
Bo.
Hey, it's Bo Dallas.
Bo, I saw Bo. Naomi likes butter on her pancake. Nothing?
Okay. Nothing.
Now she's showing the girls, the Funky Dactyls, her save the date engagement photos.
Oh my god. Naomi's reaction.
Uh-huh. I could see the cookie a little bit. Said Naomi. Oh, Titus. He's like, oh, hell no.
You put on a light t-shirt and some jeans.
And go to the beach and take a picture. Thank you, Titus. Thank you.
Can we make Titus a part of the show? Sassy Titus is kind of awesome.
It kind of is. So we've Natty and Nikki, the Funkadactyls, Eva, Natty. All the girls all main event in a battle royal.
I remember this match.
This was the number one contenders match. Right after WrestleMania.
That's right.
The one that Tamina wins here in a moment. Spoiler alert. Tamina wins.
You get it.
She got hers. We're now in Phoenix, Arizona. With Nikki and Brie. Oh no. What are they doing?
They're going to eat lunch.
Okay. Oh, how sweet. She's texting John. Good night.
Aww.
So it's like the middle of the afternoon.
Time difference. Okay. They're in Phoenix. He's in Tampa. Wait, did he just say, if I marry you, is that enough?
Yeah. That's what he said. But he's like, if he's giving you the world, if he's giving you marriage.
Yeah, I'm kind of with Brie.
She feels that John's the one, doesn't Nikki? And then Brie's bringing up, will you be satisfied if you can't have kids? And Nikki's on the hook of, but he's changing.
He's not changing fast enough, and he's not changing the way you want him to. Yeah, basically I'm with Brie. He's basically offering up marriage as a compromise to not having kids.
And then Brie's bringing up the idea of freezing Nikki's eggs. So she's not 40 and alone, has no kid.
Well, even if she's not alone, if, you know, she and John decide to have kids later in life.
Yeah.
And it's 10 grand to get this done, by the way.
Nikki believes that John will change his mind one day.
Yeah, we're going to have to wait to talk about this. So basically, she's going to look into it.
There's a fuller length clip of what John said on E's website. Yeah, they really go back and forth about it.
Yeah, just a little bit.
It doesn't sit well.
And now we're at Friday Night SmackDown. We see Mark. He's meeting with the girls.
They're all so excited for Rosa being back. Kinda, not really. Brie can't give a damn.
Dude, Brie has no love for Rosa.
No. Brie hopes she can handle the road again. Well, she came back with two size bigger boobs and a smaller waist.
Like you do.
Like you do when you go to rehab. Well, apparently no one has love for Summer either, because she's filming the movie, and Mark asked, have you keep in touch? And, like, none. None at all. No one cares about Summer. Poor Summer. And Natty's being told to hang back.
Yeah, Mark's like, well, this is awkward.
Yeah.
Basically, Natty is being asked to look out for Rosa and kind of, you know, be her big sister.
She'd rather be scrubbing her toilet bowl than dealing with Rosa. Wait, is she comparing Rosa Mendes to Jeffrey Dahmer?
I think she just did.
Wow, now she wants a title match to look after Rosa.
Okay!
A bunch of people dressed as Golda. Say, it's the Funkadactyls. Yeah. Oh my god, Natty. Anyway. So, now we have a meeting between Natty and Rosa. Natty, don't use the furry player hater, please. That does not fit you. So now he's filling in Rosa about what's going on and how she's basically the babysitter.
And well, now we're getting the honest truth. Rosa was in rehab.
This is Rosa's second chance. WWE's giving her a second chance and she has to kick ass. Rosa's like, I've had hundreds of hours of therapy. I'm okay. I'm super strong. I'm alright.
Basically, well, girl, you can say you're strong, but you need to prove it.
I know what I want. I know what I have to do. I got no choice.
Well, that's not necessarily the best thing to view at is, you know...
Oh, God.
Oh, no. Oh, Jesus. They're going to show the
family. Oh, okay, then.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
People are getting naked. People are freezing eggs. People are showing semi-dirty pictures to their parents. Oh, okay. So, where do we want to start with this?
I don't know. You bring up something you want to talk about.
You know, honestly, I think we just kind of have to hit the nail on the head with this, because we're going to get into the other stuff later. John and Nikki. I want to get into this, because...
Go right ahead.
You know, it's... The way he says it, and I'm not sure whether it was actually for TV... Or if it was that was the legit conversation that was had for them, but for a guy, if he looked at me and said, "Well, if I marry you, is that enough?"
They had a longer discussion about kids, and you know, not wanting to go have kids when he's on the road, and but is marriage enough? That sort of thing.
Notice while he's on the road. Which, given his age, John Cena is probably going to be on the road till he's in his mid to late 40s.
Another decade,
at the very, very least, which puts Nikki Bella at being 41, 42, if they're still together. But, so it's like, it's not a complete, he does not want to have kids. He doesn't want to have kids while he's on the road.
He doesn't want to be that father who goes on the road 300 days a year, doesn't see his kid, and, yeah.
Yeah, which is fine. That's great. You're seeing a lot of the guys have children later in their lives. You know, one of them is The Undertaker, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's just like, you know, for him to look at her and tell her that, you know, well, is this enough for you? Will this basically shut you the hell up about having kids and everything else if I marry you? Like, that what? No?
No, that doesn't fly.
Yeah, that doesn't fly. I mean, I get he's trying to be real with her, and he's trying to be honest with her, and that's great. But it's just, like, the way it comes across is it's basically, like, if I marry you, will you just shut up about kids?
Pretty much, he's trying to, in his mind, he's trying to compromise with her.
Yeah, and that's not love. That's not a relationship. I'm sorry, it's not.
That's not compromise.
That's not compromise. That's basically, okay, well, I'm going to give in to what you want to make you be quiet about the thing that I really don't want. So it's basically John can be persuaded to get married if the sacrifice is kids. That's basically what this is saying.
I'll put a ring on it if you give up the kid.
Yeah. Which, you know, to be fair, that's just wrong. It's just flat out wrong. I'm sorry. That's really kind of a crappy thing to say and to do. So, and Nikki freezing her eggs, you know what? Good honor for it. You know, Bree's right. You know, you know, what happens if it doesn't work out with Cena? What happens if you're alone and you gave up this chance to have children and, you know, you have that regret? At least you have the chance with a frozen egg to have a child, or say Cena comes off the road in a decade, or in even 15 years. Who knows when he's going to actually retire?
Right.
And you're already past your prime in terms of being able to have a kid, you'll have frozen eggs. And then that way it's like, hey, you know, you can get them fertilized, you could probably find a surrogate, and you could have a child together.
Right, and you could tell the one thing she wants. She wants to be a mother.
She really desperately wants to be a mother. And, you know, it's... I think it's a little cruel of him to take that away from her. Like, I get some people just don't want to have children. But if you really love someone as much as he claims to love her, that's a big thing to ask her to give up. And expect her to give up.
Very much so, yeah.
Yeah, but anyway, we're coming back from the break. We're in beautiful San Francisco. And we're in Concord, California, with Eva and Jonathan. Oh, they're heading to see the family.
She feels fine. He's calling her hot.
Eva, honey, you're not fat.
They're off to see her parents, and...
She's telling him to put on his smiley face.
Oh, good lord. He's basically like, don't throw me under the bus. he wants to be a united friend. She feels like she's doing the right thing. They're going to have the wedding ceremony.
You know what? It's absolutely the right thing. Sometimes you just got to do the thing to make the parents happy. And oh my god, Brian, what is wrong with your hair?
Brian and his ponytail. It's a thing.
It's totally a thing.
Hey, it's new WWE superstar JJ.
Yeah.
Baby fever. Brie has baby fever. Why is she playing with his ponytail?
Because she's trying to entice him to create a baby with her.
So by doing so, you play with the ponytail to entice?
You rub the hair, you know?
Rub the mane, just play with
it. Yeah.
And now they're talking about freezing Nikki's eggs. And Brie's so happy for Nikki. She says she would choose John over the kids.
But if she ends up, you know, breaking up with somebody, or breaking up with him, she can always, you know, pull an egg out of storage and have a kid.
This is true. She's going to tell John after the fact.
Well, you know... O'Brien.
Okay. Brian basically said he'll donate the sperm. And Brie was like, shut that down. No.
Actually, that's kind of a smart thing for him to freeze some sperm in addition to freezing eggs, just because, you know, say, God forbid something happens to Brian, at least then Brie can, you know, have kids with Brian.
Yeah, but you don't have that cross-sect. No. So Eva's at home, and her brother's like, are you pregnant? No, she's not pregnant. And they break the news of having the wedding. Oh. She wants to have her dad walk her down that aisle. He's pumped. Oh, no.
Oh, my God, Eva, don't do it. Just don't.
No, Eva.
Don't. Eva, no. Don't.
Eva, no. No. Oh, no. Her mom's like, I can't show these to my grandkids. Classy, not trashy, says her mother. Yeah, they don't like the photos.
Color me surprised. They're great photos. Don't get me wrong. They're nice photos, but those are not, I'm sorry, those are not save the day photos.
They're private collection photos.
They really kind of are. You know, I would, it, like, you're going to send these out to people, like all your friends and some of your family, and it's like, you really want them to see what God gave you? It's... No. Just no.
Hell no.
Good for her if she's okay with that. I'm not okay with that.
You're not going to flaunt it?
Nope.
You're not going to let the girls loose and flaunt them?
Nope.
No? Okay. Now we're...
We're going back to the gynecologist's office! First show of the season, baby!
Oh, man.
Just think of how much you're learning.
I know. I'm learning a lot about the female... What?
Stuff.
The female... Stuff. Yeah, we'll go with stuff is a good word.
But we have to... All the crap we have to go through.
Yeah. Bree wants to be a mother and a wife. So they're talking about the process now for Nikki. Oh, now we're learning about cycles and when Nikki cycles.
Well, you know, you have to make sure you catch the eggs.
She's not allowed to smoke or have alcohol. And she's not allowed to have sex either. That's Nikki's two favorite things.
Well, Nikki, honey, sometimes you just gotta sacrifice for what you want.
Okay, then. Alright. Still in San Francisco. We're back to San... We're Concord, California. Eva's brother's shown up. We're saying grace now. God bless Eva. Everyone must eat the corn on the cob. Really? Really? It's official like a referee's whistle. Really? Bree and Brian's wedding made her realize that she needs to have a full wedding.
And now she's getting grilled on the details. Oh, they're not getting married in the church. Oh, no.
Yeah, they're like, which church? Which church? And they're like, no, no church. No, Jonathan's not Catholic. And they're like, he thinks family, God, church, wedding, traditional. And they're like, why don't you convert? Go to classes, it helps. And he's not changing his views to have a traditional wedding.
Oh, she doesn't seem happy about that.
Her father's very disappointed.
And as we go to commercial, we see Rosa's first match back with Natty. And, well, she's super excited. And we see Nikki walking around the house.
Oh, no. She's going to be sneaking around. That's never going to be good.
Nope. So... I think we just have to talk about what, you know, Eva and Jonathan just kind of, you know, dropped.
Yeah, might as well talk about it.
So they're getting married again. They're having the recommitment ceremony, which, you know, hey, that's awesome. That's great. They want to do it with her family and presumably his family. I don't know if he has any. I would assume he does. I would hope he does.
We never see that side of family. When we talked to her, she was talking about the stressfulness of getting the wedding put together. And we're seeing right in front of us the first real big stressful thing.
Right, which is, you know, he's not Catholic. So they cannot do a Catholic ceremony, or they believe they cannot do a Catholic ceremony if he's not Catholic. Personally, I don't think the priest is really going to care. If you just get a priest in there and you have him take the vows, that's fine. I don't believe the priest is going to be that strict and have too much of a problem, but it's like in terms of, you know, him converting, he doesn't want to do that. Which, I can respect that.
I respect his decision not to, because you shouldn't have to.
He shouldn't have to, but to kind of do the flip side of it, what is it really going to hurt? You know, just to kind of play devil's advocate with it, because I was actually thinking about this, because I saw a clip of that part, and it was, you know, it kind of goes back to something that I saw that basically Sex and the City brought up once, which was Miranda and her boyfriend at the time had had a son, and they were going to get him baptized as, you know, a Catholic. And Miranda was freaking out about it because she didn't know about how she felt about her views on God. And one of the things that, you know, her boyfriend at the time said was, well, if you don't believe in it, isn't it just water on your head, or on the kid's head? Right. And that's kind of the same thing here for Jonathan. It's like, nobody's saying that you have to change your religious views. Nobody says you have to believe in it. But if you convert and you do it, and you do it for the sake of your family, and this more specifically the sake of Eva's family, and, you know, you kind of bend on this a little bit and kind of give them what they want to get the Catholic wedding that they want, what's really the harm? Nobody says that you have to practice it. Nobody says that you have to go to church every Sunday.
At the same time, you don't know what his how religious he is.
Oh, and I understand that completely, and I respect it. And this is just me playing devil's advocate.
Oh, I know, and I'm just that's where I'm setting it up as. We don't know his side how religious he is. Would it hurt? No. Would it make things smoother? Yes. But there are some people who are very religious. We don't know whether he is or he's not, but he seems like he is semi-religious to the point where he doesn't want to take that step because he has his own beliefs. And I'm like the worst person to ask about this because I'm not very religious, as you well know.
Oh, yeah, I know that. Well, neither am I.
Right, we're like the two worst people. Like, if there was a situation to compromise, the two of us could compromise because we're not the most religious. You can see her family's very religious. His side seems very religious. It's one of those crossing points where it's like, yeah.
I don't know if he's so much religious as he's more spiritual. I think that's the difference between him and her family is he's much more spiritual and they are much more religious. Because when her father said, you know, you get married in the church in front of the family and God, it's like, well, you know, the way that, and this is just completely personal, is that, you know, God just isn't in a church. God is everywhere, that if you believe in God. So it's like, you know, they don't necessarily have to be married in a church to be married in front of God. But that's how her family sees that. And again, I completely respect their view on that. But it's just, you know, him kind of being unyielding about, I'm not going to convert. You know, it's like, okay, but could you at least consider it for the sake of the family?
Since you've already caused a lot of problems. So,
yeah, and it's like y'all are basically doing this to make amends for the fact that you eloped, that, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with what they did, with how they got married, how they did all that. You know, all of that is their personal choice.
Well, they should eloping is fine, but breaking it like a month later is that's where,
or beyond that. Whatever. It was like, I think, 3 or 4 months after they had gotten married.
That's where going off and doing it, that's fine. Should have told people about.
Yeah, it's and that could have all been all for TV, but because again, we don't know what's actually for TV and what's actually legit. But I have a feeling they had found out well after the fact. But basically, you're doing this ceremony as a way to make amends with her family, as a way for her to, you know, have the really her dream wedding. This is what this is. You know, y'all got really what you wanted when you eloped. Y'all live your life the way that you want. Again, nothing wrong with any of this. But it's like, this is you trying to make amends with her family. You know, the least you can do in terms of when you're going to someone and you're trying to make amends is be a little bit more considerate. And, you know, it's like, I understand converting is a big deal, but it's like, at least can you just, you know, think about it.
And at the same
time, or say no.
Right. And at the same time, her family needs to bend as well.
Oh, absolutely. Her family needs to bend as well, and I'm sure we will see a compromise reached in terms of the wedding where it's, and like I said, most priests nowadays really don't care. you know, you can get a priest to marry you. They're not necessarily going to ask you if you're Catholic.
Right. It all depends. Again, that depends on the church and whatever. But most priests will be fine with it.
Yeah, if you make a donation to the church, they're really not going to ask any questions.
That's all they care about.
Yeah, it's they want the money for the church. So if you throw the priest a little bit extra for the church, usually they're pretty cool with it, and they'll do it. And it doesn't really matter.
Right, the priests are very open to doing what you want.
Yeah, so it's kind of a moot point, and we'll have to see how it goes as the season progresses. But we are coming back from commercial. And, well, we're at John and Nikki's house. They're in Tampa.
Yay!
And they're bringing in an interior decorator.
Okay, then. They've done a very Downton Abbey. Oh, one of the dressers.
That's not Downton Abbey, honey.
Uh-oh.
She's on day three of her period, and she's wearing white pants.
Uh-huh.
She is brave.
And
wow, she is brave.
Uh-huh, and the nurse is coming to draw some blood from her.
To the house.
While John's all dressed up for the interior designer. Oh, look at John. He's very handy with a tape measure.
And he sees her walk away. He's not the least bit thrilled about any of this. You can tell.
Of course she schedules this for both, you know.
At the same time as the interior designer, they're doing this. As, you know.
Oh, this is gonna go bad. I can already tell.
Oh, blood needle. Ah!
She's taking blood, taking it out. John's walking around with the, there's the blood. Oh, yeah. And more blood. You can look now.
Okay.
Lindsey doesn't like blood.
I do like blood. I just don't like it. Like, seeing medical stuff bothers me. Like, I can handle blood in wrestling, I just can't handle blood in every other application.
Right. I love how she's hiding her arm.
Because, you know, she's not going to show a bruise or anything there.
No. So she quickly goes and gets the check, and, yeah, rips off the bandage, and is like, oh, yeah, all right. Yeah, okay, whatever.
And now we're in the hotel with Natty, and oh my god, Rosa is completely naked.
Yeah, she is.
Holy naked Rosa. Oh, poor Natty.
Uh-huh. She looks like she just walked into a softcore porn.
Oh, poor Natty. She's just, like, in hell right now.
Uh-huh. She's very uncomfortable with Rosa being naked. And
she wants to show off her boob job. I have no words. I just have none. Holy naked Rosa, though, is my new favorite expression.
Holy naked Rosa. Hashtag
it,
people.
Holy naked Rosa.
Holy naked Rosa. Hashtag. Okay, we're with Jonathan and Eva's Marie and her mother, and they're going to get some coffee to relax. And the phone rings. It's her father. Talk about chicken. It's sugar levels and stuff. Eva's tan looks so fake. Just pointing that one out. Looks very fake.
And, well, we're getting serious because chemo shot just got brought up.
Yeah, so her father has to get some more chemo shots. He had cancer in the past, and now he had colon cancer, and now he beat it. But now he's back taking shots.
Which means it's come back.
Apparently it's all over. I...
Holy Naked Rosa, just Holy Naked Rosa.
Alright, so...
As we're at commercial... Go. Just go.
I have no words. I'm speechless. I am speechless after Holy Naked Rosa. Poor Natty. Poor Natty. That's all I got. What do you have?
Yeah, poor Natty. Just poor Natty. You know, it's like... I know we all have the same, you know, girls, we all have the same equipment, but that doesn't mean we all want to see each other naked. Just a walk-in. The thing is, it's like walking in, and it's not just Natty. It's Natty and a camera guy, and a sound guy,
a producer,
a director, a producer. You know, she's probably got 4 or 5 people with her shooting this, and there's a naked Rosa Mendes. In the middle of the room, knowing she's going to come in with a camera crew.
And here's all my business, top and bottom.
Yeah, there's all her business. Clearly all her business. She's not wearing any type of nude thong or anything like that. No. Wow.
All right, I can understand being topless if you want to show off the boobs. Why are you fully naked?
Yeah, Hey, you know what? If you want to be fully naked and you want to walk around your house fully naked, I fully support that.
This is a hotel room.
This is a hotel room where you're going to have a camera crew walking in with a co-worker. Not even a female co-worker. A co-worker. You know, it's like, wait, what? You're going to do okay. You know, it's like, again, not trying to judge, but I can respect it, but it's like, Holy Naked Rosa, oh my god. Can we not? Please, can we not? I don't want to see that much of her. No offense. I'm sure the boob job is really quite lovely, but no. No thank you.
Hashtag Holy Naked Rosa.
Stealing that. So stealing that. Anyway, we are coming back from break, and we're with the Eva Marie family, because I don't know what else to call them.
Yeah, we don't know her last name. It's Marie, I guess. I don't know.
And she's finding out about the cancer, and basically she's the last one to find out.
Yeah, he gets a shot in his hip. Once a month in his hip. Her father doesn't want her to worry, so he doesn't tell her. And now it's like, she wants him to be around to walk her down the aisle. Woo!
And they're telling her, don't worry, it's not that bad. Basically, it's a non-operable form of cancer, and they're trying to treat it for as long as they can. But it seems that her father has a terminal illness, unfortunately.
Which they say will be years.
Which will be years. But Eva is obviously none too happy.
So we make the awkward transition to the gynecologist again. The fertility clinic. And now we're going to see how fertile Nikki is. Oh, the things you learn on this show, I swear to God. Oh, we're doing... Now she's laying back, spread open. And who's at the very end? Brie. and Brie get to see all her business. Brie solos.
I don't know why you're being upset. You have the same thing.
But it's not. It wasn't seeing the thing. It was seeing it being something being inserted into her thing. And apparently Nikki is very fertile. Nikki is very fertile. Shock of shocks. I know.
So she's very happy. She's very fertile.
And when she takes the medication for 10 days, no sex, no alcohol, no wrestling for 10 days. Which would explain why she was out of action for like 3 weeks in April.
That would explain that, yeah.
Huh. It was that period where... Alright, can we have a different picture of the bridge for transitions, please?
Nope. It's the only one they got.
They go left. One time they go left, the other way they go right. It's the same bridge. Shot. Now we're going back more serious with Eva and Jonathan.
And now we're getting serious.
Jonathan's like, your dad's tough. Vietnam didn't get him. He's already beating cancer. But it's about her. She wants to make her father happy.
And basically she poses what we posed earlier, which is, this is the worst thing for you to convert.
Yeah, so he's like, yeah, it is. It is the worst thing.
Okay.
Oh, man. All right, where do you want to begin?
Well, briefing out. And again, it's the same thing with Maddie. It's like, Bree's like, I don't want to see it.
I know it exists. I didn't expect to see your hoo-ha get something get inserted into your hoo-ha.
Yes, actually, it's not even that bad. Just pointing that out. If you've ever had it done.
No, I've never had something inserted into my hoo-ha.
You've never had something inserted into your hoo-ha?
I have not had a metal prod inserted into my hoo-ha.
It's not metal, it's plastic.
Okay, I've never had a plastic something stuck into my hoo-ha, okay?
Oh, well then we need to take you to the proctologist.
No, we don't. We're not sticking anything.
You see all the crap we have to put up with? See this, guys? This is what we have to go through. We have to get things stuck in our hoo-ha. If there are any guys that actually listen to this show.
Oh my god.
But yeah, so, and also, you know, getting serious, Eva. You know, we obviously have to talk about Eva and poor Eva in the sense that finding out about her father and that he's ill and things are not going well there and, you know, that she was the last one to find out. That's gotta be really rough.
Yeah, and it's been a while, so...
Yeah, so it's like they kind of kept that secret from her and didn't tell her until she was there.
That's kind of sort of payback, a little bit.
Yeah, I kind of think that was a little bit of a F you to her. Just a little bit, you know, in terms of... Because she's like, well, where the hell was I? And they're like, you were on the road, you were busy. You know, you were here. And then, you know, you can pick up a phone, she's got a cell phone.
Right, and she mentioned to us in the interview, go back and Rock Radio Show on WildTalkRadio.com, listen to it, that family is very important to her.
Oh, absolutely. Her family is everything to her. It shows. And, you know, obviously she's trying to do right by her family right now. And, you know, it's a difficult situation all the way around. It's an awkward situation because she knows she made the very brave decision to defy her family. And, you know, elope with Jonathan and start her life with Jonathan without her family involved. And now, especially since they did not give their blessing for the wedding or for the marriage or anything like that, that they really don't even approve of him. And now they're trying to go back and they're trying to make those amends, and the family's not going to make it difficult or not going to make it easy for them to do that. And obviously they're going to need to compromise on some things, and the family will as well.
Right.
But we'll have to see how it goes.
Yes, we will.
As we come back from break with yet another shot of the bridge.
This time coming the other way. And we're back with, would it be the worst thing? And he's like, no, that would be the worst thing. That would be. It's a spiritual belief, as you mentioned before. Mm-hmm. He goes, God, then family. He can't change his beliefs. It defines who he is. He's like, he's talking about how could her father respect a man to change his beliefs for one day? And I kind of see his point, kind of.
I can see his point, but at the same time, it's not just a day. It's really the rest of his life.
Right.
And it's the rest of her family's lives as well, in the fact that this is something that will essentially bring him into the fold. This will bring him into the family because he can now fully be a part of the family, as opposed to just kind of being an outsider.
Right, and it's going to be a stressful thing.
Yes, very stressful, you can already tell. She's trying to do right by her family, but it's an awkward situation.
Now we're with the Bellas in the car. And now Bree's talking about seeing something being inserted into her hoo-ha. How Nikki has an ugly hoo-ha.
She's like, you have the same one, shut up.
All she needs to do is give herself a shot. And like, how are you going to have shots from John? And like, she's going to keep them in her purse. And do it in the bathroom. And just, you know, hide it. In the secret bathroom. Oh, that's not going to go well. I can already feel it. Hey, there was a different shot of the bridge.
All right!
They listened. And we're back at the house with Eva and Jonathan. And she's very sad and just going over to her father and she's going to do whatever she can to have the Catholic wedding. And he's very happy about it.
Yes, he is.
It's going to be special. He's very proud of her. He's very proud of her.
And what she's accomplished, yes. It's a very, very touching moment between them.
Yeah.
Especially seeing as where we kind of left them last season.
Yeah, they've sort of made some amends and she's all about making her father happy. Oh, yeah, so. Alright. Where shall we begin?
I don't know, man.
This show is supposed to be about fun. We throughout this show tonight, we've gone from hilarity to very, very, very serious.
We've gone from holy naked Rosa to, oh my god, cancer.
Religion and cancer, yeah.
Yeah, two very, very heavy subjects. But, you know, it's a very real situation, and it's, again, we've talked about it, and it is what it is, and they will get it worked out. We've said that many times. You know, obviously, we need to talk about Nikki we need to kind of go back to Nikki a little bit and the whole egg freezing process and, you know, how she's not informing John of this, which she doesn't necessarily have to say something to him while she's having it done. You know, it might be nice for her to say something of, oh, hey, by the way, you know, I'm going to freeze my eggs, so I'm going to have to take hormones, just, you know, FYI. She's not going to.
No, she's not going to. And there just seems so many secrets in this relationship. It's like, holy Jesus.
Yeah, that seems to be the trend with her and John, where, especially on her side, she keeps a lot of secrets from him. And I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I'm pretty sure it's a big bad thing for her to be sitting there keeping all these secrets from him. Especially when he's not as trusting of her, and you can kind of see that sometimes.
Yeah.
That he does not 100% trust her all the time.
Well, she's giving him reasons not to trust her.
Oh yeah, he's 100% giving her reasons, you know, giving him reasons not to trust her, because it's, she's coming, you know, she's basically hiding things from him, and it, you know, the true goal of any relationship is 100% honesty with each other and not keeping secrets from each other and hiding things from each other. And if you can't get past that, you really can't have a relationship.
Right. That's very, very true.
And it's just like, Nikki, you know, sometimes you just got to put your big girl panties on and tell him. Like, you know, eventually she will tell him. But it's just like, you know, the whole, oh, I got married before thing from last season. It's like, you know, if he gets pissed about it, he gets pissed about it. If he leaves you, well, then he's a dick. Because you know what? It's a wedding that happened 10, 15 years ago. You're divorced, you've moved on, and you're happy. He's been previously married. It's not like he can say any, you know, any different.
Right. And at least to me, if you're in a relationship of any kind, honesty is key. And if you find out the person you trust the most is hiding stuff from you, that breaks all trust.
Yeah, and you honestly cannot have love without trust. You really, really, truly can't. It's not possible, because you can only love someone so much if you don't trust them.
If you don't trust the person, there is no love, because, yeah, it's just, there isn't. As much as you love a person, if you can't trust them, there's no point in being with them, because you'll always be questioning them one way or another. That's why the best relationships are ones that are full of trust. And that's how, and you should feel comfortable talking to the person about anything.
Yeah. So hopefully Nikki kind of bucks up and tells John, you know,
before soon. Before he finds out.
Yeah, before he finds out.
Which he probably will, because, well, you see, he's going to wonder why he ain't getting any.
Well, to be fair, he's got a busy schedule, so she can just say, oh, hey, you know, I just can't right now. And leave it at that. I mean, she didn't necessarily have to justify it, but we'll see how it goes. But as we come back from break,
We're in Toledo.
We're in Toledo, Ohio! We see them setting up the set for Monday Night Raw. And, well, Natty and Rosa are arriving. They're saying hi to folks.
Hey, it's Cody Rhodes.
Hey, Cody.
Rose is
freaking out because everybody's watching her.
As it's her first match back tonight.
She walks very awkwardly.
Yeah.
Wow, Titus. Way to make her freak out.
You look tired as hell, girl. Naomi's like, it's her first match back. Get your popcorn ready. And Rosa hears it, and she's not happy about it. She doesn't want to be laughed at. She doesn't want to be laughed at. So she's getting ready for... Was that Bo again?
Yeah, that's Bo.
Okay.
Bo Dallas, the next star of Total Divas. Somebody make this happen.
God, he needs his own reality show.
He does!
Well, we'll talk about that another time. So Rose is getting ready for her match. She's getting in the ring. It's Natty versus Rosa, I believe, is the match itself. With the SmackDown. Alright, whatever. And Natty's with a big clothesline and a suplex. works over the arm. Rosa gets to the ropes. Play by play. Go behind. Take over. Big clothesline. Uh-oh. She's got her. She's got her. Locked it in. Locked it in. She's going to tap. She's going to tap. She taps out. All she wrote for Rosa Mendes.
Sadly.
I didn't see much offense from Rosa Mendes, but she'll get her next time.
I remember that match. It was very short and very sweet. There wasn't a lot of offense. And, well, Rosa's pissed because she thinks she sucked.
She totally messed up. She wasn't on her game. She didn't feel good out there. The girls are just watching what's going on. Now he's like, don't worry about anyone else. Worry about yourself. She's crying now. Go give her a hug. She needs a hug.
Well, you know, she's got to stop smiling while she's crying.
Yeah, so as we go to the break, where do you want to begin?
I really got nothing beyond, you know, it's like Rosa, you know, Rosa sitting there and it's like, you know, I don't want to be laughed at. I don't want to be made fun of. Well, you know, it's, you know, you've got a lot to prove.
Yeah, she's in a position where she has to prove a lot to a lot of people.
Yeah, and it's something of, you know, they obviously all know her reputation. Clearly, a lot of the divas are not happy that she's back because that's one less, you know, that's one more spot that has to be filled, you know, or somebody that's going to take time away from them on TV. Obviously, they're not too overly happy about her being a part of the reality show.
Yeah, it's taking TV time away on the reality show.
Yeah, so it's clearly they're not happy because Rosa's reputation can't affect them all because now they're all tied to her, they're all connected to her, so if she screws up, then, you know, obviously it's going to look bad on them, especially, you know, Natty, because Natty's now kind of her big sister. But at the same time, it's like, you know what, Rosa, you sometimes, again, I'm going to say this phrase, you got to put your big girl panties on and you got to deal with it. And it's, so they're laughing at you. Big whoop. Go prove them wrong. Go show them what you can do. Nothing shuts a hater up like proving the hater wrong.
Pretty much, yeah.
So it's like, you know, you went through all this rehab, you went through all this stuff to make yourself better, to make yourself into a better person. Show them that. Show them that you're not the same person that left. Show them that you're not a laughing stock. And when you do, that's when they'll shut up.
Exactly.
As we come back from break. Also, Rosa, if you're trying to act and you're crying, don't smile.
Yeah, yeah.
Just, you know.
Pointing that out.
Pointing that out. As we see Cameron and Eva standing by laughing at her. And she's upset. Aw, Natty has to hug her. And Natty gives her the pep talk.
Everyone's backstage waiting for you to fail. Don't prove them right. Prove them wrong. She's going to fix her hair up. Wipe the tears out of her eyes. And hey, look, there's a smile. And they hug again.
Oh, Natty, you're such a good big sister.
Keep bringing the hate, she says. Keep bringing it. And now we're in San Diego, California.
And we're at the beach house.
John and Nicole's beach house. Open a bottle of wine. And John finds the stuff.
Oh, no. John found the drugs.
Dum, dum, dum. And now we're getting the season preview, the full-on preview. Oh, God. Bree's like, you should wear panties. And wow. Oh, okay, then.
Alright, we're going to stripper classes.
Yeah. Oh, they're chanting Bree Mode. Someone fought up at Bella Falls. We have ostriches. Summer Rae's back. Oh, God. We see her on the movie set. Oh.
And Brian's injury.
Bree quitting, slapping Steph. What if I borrowed money from you and John? Says Bree, because they're fired and have to work. What? Oh my Jesus.
Is Rosa go both ways?
Apparently.
All right. This just got interesting.
Natty and TJ go to counseling. Something about Lucy's not being able to have kids. There's the therapy. Oh, girl fight on the street.
Oh, my.
Oh,
my Jesus is going down this season.
Okay, then.
All right.
That was episode one. Oh my.
I can't wait for episode two.
This season's gonna be as we mentioned with Eva. Oh, they go right for it, and holy crap, it's gonna be one of those seasons.
I
like drama. Lindsey likes drama. This is gonna be epic.
Yeah. Lots and lots and lots and lots of drama. Can't wait.
It's going to be epic.
It's totally going to be epic. That's Holy Naked Rosa. It's going to be epic.
Hashtag. For the show, the name of this show right now, hashtag.
Holy Naked Rosa?
Holy Naked Rosa. And I completely forgot it for like 2 seconds. I had Naked Rosa. I forgot the word began with an H. Holy Naked Rosa. Hashtag it. It's the name of the show. Holy hashtag Holy Naked Rosa. The Rack Extra, Total Divas, Season 3, Episode 1, hashtag Holy Naked Rosa.
Holy Naked Rosa. It's in the books. Episode 1, Season 3. I say we get out of here because, well, we've got to catch our breath. Because next week we're coming back with Episode 2.
Holy Naked Rosa.
Holy Naked Rosa. So you've been listening to The Rock Extra right here on WildTalkRadio.com, and we will be back next week with Season 3, Episode 2. Till then, bye!
Holy Naked Rosa!